For quite some time, science educators believed that hands-on activities were the answer to children's understanding through their participation in science-related activities. Many teachers believed that students merely engaging in activities and manipulating objects would organize the information to be gained and the knowledge to be understood into concept comprehension. Educators began to notice that the pendulum had swung too far to the hands-on component of inquiry, as they realized that the knowledge was not inherent in the materials themselves, but in the thought and metacognition about what students had done in the activity. We now know that hands-on is a dangerous phrase when speaking about learning science. The missing ingredient is the minds-on part of the instructional experience. Certainty about the knowledge intended in any activity comes from each student's recreation of concepts and discussing, thinking, arguing, listening, and evaluating one's own preconceptions after the activities, under the leadership of a thoughtful teacher, can bring this about. After all, a food fight is a hands-on activity, but about all you would learn was something about the aerodynamics of flying mashed potatoes. Our view of what students need to build their knowledge and theories about the natural world extends far beyond a hands-on activity. While it is important for students to use and interact with materials in science class, the learning comes from the sense-making of students' hands-on experiences. The colors of the trees looked like they were on fire, the reds and oranges competing with the yellows and golds. This was Nina's favorite season, but she remained silent for hours while Marie was driving. Nina had been heartbroken after losing her championship belt. Now a former champion, she was thinking of retiring from boxing. Marie, her longtime friend and trainer, shared her pain. After another silent hour, Marie and Nina saw a sign, Sable Falls. Marie thought this would be a good place for them to stop. Marie pulled over into the parking lot. Marie and Nina went down a path to watch the falls. Another sign, Watch Your Step. Rocks are slippery. They found the falls spilling out in various layers of rock. No one was there except them. Look at them. Marie pointed to movement in the water moving toward the falls. Hundreds of fishtails were flashing and catching light from the sun, moving upstream. Beneath them in the water, they saw salmon slowly moving their bodies. While Marie and Nina kept watching the salmon, a big one suddenly leapt. It threw itself up and over the rushing water above, but in vain. They were standing without a word and watching the fish struggling. Another jumped, its body spinning until it made it over the falls. Another one leapt and was washed back by the power of the water. Watching the salmon, Marie noticed Nina fixing her eyes on their continuing challenge. Nina's heart was beating fast at each leap and twist. Then, with a great push, a small one turned a complete circle and made it over the falls. He made it. Nina shouted at the success with admiration. More salmon then followed and succeeded. She felt ashamed to be looking at them. After a moment, she turned to Marie and said, "Giving up is not in my vocabulary. Marie, I'll get my championship belt back." Marie nodded with a bright smile. "Our training begins tomorrow. It's going to be tough. Are you ready?" Walking up the path and back to the car, they could still hear the fish splashing in the water. For quite some time, science educators believed that hands-on activities were the answer to children's understanding through their participation in science-related activities. Many teachers believed that students merely engaging in activities and manipulating objects would organize the information to be gained and the knowledge to be understood into concept comprehension. Educators began to notice that the pendulum had swung too far to the hands-on component of inquiry, as they realized that the knowledge was not inherent in the materials themselves, but in the thought and metacognition about what students had done in the activity. We now know that hands-on is a dangerous phrase when speaking about learning science. The missing ingredient is the minds-on part of the instructional experience. Certainty about the knowledge intended in any activity comes from each student's recreation of concepts and discussing, thinking, arguing, listening, and evaluating one's own preconceptions after the activities, under the leadership of a thoughtful teacher, can bring this about. After all, a food fight is a hands-on activity, but about all you would learn was something about the aerodynamics of flying mashed potatoes. Our view of what students need to build their knowledge and theories about the natural world extends far beyond a hands-on activity. While it is important for students to use and interact with materials in science class, The learning comes from the sense making of students' hands-on experiences. The colors of the trees looked like they were on fire, the reds and oranges competing with the yellows and golds. This was Nina's favorite season, but she remained silent for hours while Marie was driving. Nina had been heartbroken after losing her championship belt. Now a former champion, she was thinking of retiring from boxing. Marie, her longtime friend and trainer, shared her pain. After another silent hour, Marie and Nina saw a sign, Sable Falls. Marie thought this would be a good place for them to stop. Marie pulled over into the parking lot. Marie and Nina went down a path to watch the falls. Another sign, watch your step. Rocks are slippery. They found the falls spilling out in various layers of rock. No one was there except them. Look at them. Marie pointed to movement in the water moving toward the falls. Hundreds of fishtails were flashing and catching light from the sun, moving upstream. Beneath them in the water, they saw salmon slowly moving their bodies. While Marie and Nina kept watching the salmon, a big one suddenly leapt. It threw itself up and over the rushing water above, but in vain. They were standing without a word and watching the fish struggling. Another jumped, its body spinning until it made it over the falls. Another one leapt and was washed back by the power of the water. Watching the salmon, Marie noticed Nina fixing her eyes on their continuing challenge. Nina's heart was beating fast at each leap and twist. Then, with a great push, a small one turned a complete circle and made it over the falls. He made it. Nina shouted at the success with admiration. More salmon then followed and succeeded. She felt ashamed to be looking at them. After a moment, she turned to Marie and said, "Giving up is not in my vocabulary. Marie, I'll get my championship belt back." Marie nodded with a bright smile. "Our training begins tomorrow. It's going to be tough. Are you ready?" Walking up the path and back to the car, they could still hear the fish splashing in the water. For quite some time, science educators believed that hands-on activities were the answer to children's understanding through their participation in science-related activities. Many teachers believed that students merely engaging in activities and manipulating objects would organize the information to be gained and the knowledge to be understood into concept comprehension. Educators began to notice that the pendulum had swung too far to the hands-on component of inquiry, as they realized that the knowledge was not inherent in the materials themselves, but in the thought and metacognition about what students had done in the activity. We now know that hands-on is a dangerous phrase when speaking about learning science. The missing ingredient is the minds-on part of the instructional experience. Certainty about the knowledge intended in any activity comes from each student's recreation of concepts and discussing, thinking, arguing, listening, and evaluating one's own preconceptions after the activities, under the leadership of a thoughtful teacher, can bring this about. After all, a food fight is a hands-on activity, but about all you would learn was something about the aerodynamics of flying mashed potatoes. Our view of what students need to build their knowledge and theories about the natural world extends far beyond a hands-on activity. While it is important for students to use and interact with materials in science class, the learning comes from the sense-making of students' hands-on experiences. The colors of the trees looked like they were on fire, the reds and oranges competing with the yellows and golds. This was Nina's favorite season, but she remained silent for hours while Marie was driving. Nina had been heartbroken after losing her championship belt. Now a former champion, she was thinking of retiring from boxing. Marie, her longtime friend and trainer, shared her pain. After another silent hour, Marie and Nina saw a sign, Sable Falls. Marie thought this would be a good place for them to stop. Marie pulled over into the parking lot. Marie and Nina went down a path to watch the falls. Another sign, watch your step. Rocks are slippery. They found the falls spilling out in various layers of rock. No one was there except them. Look at them. Marie pointed to movement in the water moving toward the falls. Hundreds of fishtails were flashing and catching light from the sun, moving upstream. Beneath them in the water, they saw salmon slowly moving their bodies. While Marie and Nina kept watching the salmon, a big one suddenly leapt. It threw itself up and over the rushing water above, but in vain. They were standing without a word and watching the fish struggling. Another jumped, its body spinning until it made it over the falls. Another one leapt and was washed back by the power of the water. Watching the salmon, Marie noticed Nina fixing her eyes on their continuing challenge. Nina's heart was beating fast at each leap and twist. Then, with a great push, a small one turned a complete circle and made it over the falls. He made it. Nina shouted at the success with admiration. More salmon then followed and succeeded. She felt ashamed to be looking at them. After a moment, she turned to Marie and said, "Giving up is not in my vocabulary. Marie, I'll get my championship belt back." Marie nodded with a bright smile. "Our training begins tomorrow. It's going to be tough. Are you ready?" Walking up the path and back to the car, they could still hear the fish splashing in the water. For quite some time, science educators believed that hands-on activities were the answer to children's understanding through their participation in science-related activities. Many teachers believed that students merely engaging in activities and manipulating objects would organize the information to be gained and the knowledge to be understood into concept comprehension. Educators began to notice that the pendulum had swung too far to the hands-on component of inquiry, as they realized that the knowledge was not inherent in the materials themselves, but in the thought and metacognition about what students had done in the activity. We now know that hands-on is a dangerous phrase when speaking about learning science. The missing ingredient is the minds-on part of the instructional experience. Certainty about the knowledge intended in any activity comes from each student's recreation of concepts and discussing, thinking, arguing, listening, and evaluating one's own preconceptions after the activities, under the leadership of a thoughtful teacher, can bring this about. After all, a food fight is a hands-on activity, but about all you would learn was something about the aerodynamics of flying mashed potatoes. Our view of what students need to build their knowledge and theories about the natural world extends far beyond a hands-on activity. While it is important for students to use and interact with materials in science class, the learning comes from the sense-making of students' hands-on experiences. The colors of the trees looked like they were on fire, the reds and oranges competing with the yellows and golds. This was Nina's favorite season, but she remained silent for hours while Marie was driving. Nina had been heartbroken after losing her championship belt. Now a former champion, she was thinking of retiring from boxing. Marie, her longtime friend and trainer, shared her pain. After another silent hour, Marie and Nina saw a sign, "Sable Falls." Marie thought this would be a good place for them to stop. Marie pulled over into the parking lot. Marie and Nina went down a path to watch the falls. Another sign, "Watch your step. Rocks are slippery." They found the falls spilling out in various layers of rock. No one was there except them. "Look at them." Marie pointed to movement in the water moving toward the falls. Hundreds of fishtails were flashing and catching light from the sun, moving upstream. Beneath them in the water, they saw salmon slowly moving their bodies. While Marie and Nina kept watching the salmon, a big one suddenly leapt. It threw itself up and over the rushing water above, but in vain. They were standing without a word and watching the fish struggling. Another jumped, its body spinning until it made it over the falls. Another one leapt and was washed back by the power of the water. Watching the salmon, Marie noticed Nina fixing her eyes on their continuing challenge. Nina's heart was beating fast at each leap and twist. Then, with a great push, a small one turned a complete circle and made it over the falls. He made it. Nina shouted at the success with admiration. More salmon then followed and succeeded. She felt ashamed to be looking at them. After a moment, she turned to Marie and said, "Giving up is not in my vocabulary. Marie, I'll get my championship belt back." Marie nodded with a bright smile. "Our training begins tomorrow. It's going to be tough. Are you ready?" Walking up the path and back to the car, they could still hear the fish splashing in the water. For quite some time, science educators believed that hands-on activities were the answer to children's understanding through their participation in science-related activities. Many teachers believed that students merely engaging in activities and manipulating objects would organize the information to be gained and the knowledge to be understood into concept comprehension. Educators began to notice that the pendulum had swung too far to the hands-on component of inquiry, as they realized that the knowledge was not inherent in the materials themselves, but in the thought and metacognition about what students had done in the activity. We now know that hands-on is a dangerous phrase when speaking about learning science. The missing ingredient is the minds-on part of the instructional experience. Certainty about the knowledge intended in any activity comes from each student's recreation of concepts and discussing, thinking, arguing, listening, and evaluating one's own preconceptions after the activities, under the leadership of a thoughtful teacher, can bring this about. After all, a food fight is a hands-on activity, but about all you would learn was something about the aerodynamics of flying mashed potatoes. Our view of what students need to build their knowledge and theories about the natural world extends far beyond a hands-on activity. While it is important for students to use and interact with materials in science class, the learning comes from the sense-making of students' hands-on experiences. The colors of the trees looked like they were on fire, the reds and oranges competing with the yellows and golds. This was Nina's favorite season, but she remained silent for hours while Marie was driving. Nina had been heartbroken after losing her championship belt. Now a former champion, she was thinking of retiring from boxing. Marie, her longtime friend and trainer, shared her pain. After another silent hour, Marie and Nina saw a sign, Sable Falls. Marie thought this would be a good place for them to stop. Marie pulled over into the parking lot. Marie and Nina went down a path to watch the falls. Another sign, watch your step. Rocks are slippery. They found the falls spilling out in various layers of rock. No one was there except them. Look at them. Marie pointed to movement in the water moving toward the falls. Hundreds of fishtails were flashing and catching light from the sun, moving upstream. Beneath them in the water, they saw salmon slowly moving their bodies. While Marie and Nina kept watching the salmon, a big one suddenly leapt. It threw itself up and over the rushing water above, but in vain. They were standing without a word and watching the fish struggling. Another jumped, its body spinning until it made it over the falls. Another one leapt and was washed back by the power of the water. Watching the salmon, Marie noticed Nina fixing her eyes on their continuing challenge. Nina's heart was beating fast at each leap and twist. Then, with a great push, a small one turned a complete circle and made it over the falls. He made it. Nina shouted at the success with admiration. More salmon then followed and succeeded. She felt ashamed to be looking at them. After a moment, she turned to Marie and said, "Giving up is not in my vocabulary. Marie, I'll get my championship belt back." Marie nodded with a bright smile. "Our training begins tomorrow. It's going to be tough. Are you ready?" Walking up the path and back to the car, they could still hear the fish splashing in the water. For quite some time, science educators believed that hands-on activities were the answer to children's understanding through their participation in science-related activities. Many teachers believed that students merely engaging in activities and manipulating objects would organize the information to be gained and the knowledge to be understood into concept comprehension. Educators began to notice that the pendulum had swung too far to the hands-on component of inquiry, as they realized that the knowledge was not inherent in the materials themselves, but in the thought and metacognition about what students had done in the activity. We now know that hands-on is a dangerous phrase when speaking about learning science. The missing ingredient is the minds-on part of the instructional experience. Certainty about the knowledge intended in any activity comes from each student's recreation of concepts and discussing, thinking, arguing, listening, and evaluating one's own preconceptions after the activities, under the leadership of a thoughtful teacher, can bring this about. After all, a food fight is a hands-on activity, but about all you would learn was something about the aerodynamics of flying mashed potatoes. Our view of what students need to build their knowledge and theories about the natural world extends far beyond a hands-on activity. While it is important for students to use and interact with materials in science class, the learning comes from the sense-making of students' hands-on experiences. The colors of the trees looked like they were on fire, the reds and oranges competing with the yellows and golds. This was Nina's favorite season, but she remained silent for hours while Marie was driving. Nina had been heartbroken after losing her championship belt. Now a former champion, she was thinking of retiring from boxing. Marie, her longtime friend and trainer, shared her pain. After another silent hour, Marie and Nina saw a sign, Sable Falls. Marie thought this would be a good place for them to stop. Marie pulled over into the parking lot. Marie and Nina went down a path to watch the falls. Another sign, watch your step. Rocks are slippery. They found the falls spilling out in various layers of rock. No one was there except them. Look at them. Marie pointed to movement in the water moving toward the falls. Hundreds of fishtails were flashing and catching light from the sun, moving upstream. Beneath them in the water, they saw salmon slowly moving their bodies. While Marie and Nina kept watching the salmon, a big one suddenly leapt. It threw itself up and over the rushing water above, but in vain. They were standing without a word and watching the fish struggling. Another jumped, its body spinning until it made it over the falls. Another one leapt and was washed back by the power of the water. Watching the salmon, Marie noticed Nina fixing her eyes on their continuing challenge. Nina's heart was beating fast at each leap and twist. Then, with a great push, a small one turned a complete circle and made it over the falls. He made it. Nina shouted at the success with admiration. More salmon then followed and succeeded. She felt ashamed to be looking at them. After a moment, she turned to Marie and said, "Giving up is not in my vocabulary. Marie, I'll get my championship belt back." Marie nodded with a bright smile. "Our training begins tomorrow. It's going to be tough. Are you ready?" Walking up the path and back to the car, they could still hear the fish splashing in the water. For quite some time, science educators believed that hands-on activities were the answer to children's understanding through their participation in science-related activities. Many teachers believed that students merely engaging in activities and manipulating objects would organize the information to be gained and the knowledge to be understood into concept comprehension. Educators began to notice that the pendulum had swung too far to the hands-on component of inquiry, as they realized that the knowledge was not inherent in the materials themselves, but in the thought and metacognition about what students had done in the activity. We now know that hands-on is a dangerous phrase when speaking about learning science. The missing ingredient is the minds-on part of the instructional experience. Certainty about the knowledge intended in any activity comes from each student's recreation of concepts, and discussing, thinking, arguing, listening, and evaluating one's own preconceptions after the activities, under the leadership of a thoughtful teacher, can bring this about. After all, a food fight is a hands-on activity, but about all you would learn was something about the aerodynamics of flying mashed potatoes. Our view of what students need to build their knowledge and theories about the natural world extends far beyond a hands-on activity. While it is important for students to use and interact with materials in science class, the learning comes from the sense-making of students' hands-on experiences. The colors of the trees looked like they were on fire, the reds and oranges competing with the yellows and golds. This was Nina's favorite season, but she remained silent for hours while Marie was driving. Nina had been heartbroken after losing her championship belt. Now a former champion, she was thinking of retiring from boxing. Marie, her longtime friend and trainer, shared her pain. After another silent hour, Marie and Nina saw a sign, "Sable Falls." Marie thought this would be a good place for them to stop. Marie pulled over into the parking lot. Marie and Nina went down a path to watch the falls. Another sign, "Watch your step. Rocks are slippery." They found the falls spilling out in various layers of rock. No one was there except them. Look at them. Marie pointed to movement in the water moving toward the falls. Hundreds of fishtails were flashing and catching light from the sun, moving upstream. Beneath them in the water, they saw salmon slowly moving their bodies. While Marie and Nina kept watching the salmon, a big one suddenly leapt. It threw itself up and over the rushing water above, but in vain. They were standing without a word and watching the fish struggling. Another jumped, its body spinning until it made it over the falls. Another one leapt and was washed back by the power of the water. Watching the salmon, Marie noticed Nina fixing her eyes on their continuing challenge. Nina's heart was beating fast at each leap and twist. Then, with a great push, a small one turned a complete circle and made it over the falls. He made it. Nina shouted at the success with admiration. More salmon then followed and succeeded. She felt ashamed to be looking at them. After a moment, she turned to Marie and said, "Giving up is not in my vocabulary. Marie, I'll get my championship belt back." Marie nodded with a bright smile. Our training begins tomorrow. It's going to be tough. Are you ready? Walking up the path and back to the car, they could still hear the fish splashing in the water. For quite some time, science educators believed that hands-on activities were the answer to children's understanding through their participation in science-related activities. Many teachers believed that students merely engaging in activities and manipulating objects would organize the information to be gained and the knowledge to be understood into concept comprehension. Educators began to notice that the pendulum had swung too far to the hands-on component of inquiry, as they realized that the knowledge was not inherent in the materials themselves, but in the thought and metacognition about what students had done in the activity. We now know that hands-on is a dangerous phrase when speaking about learning science. The missing ingredient is the minds-on part of the instructional experience. Certainty about the knowledge intended in any activity comes from each student's recreation of concepts, and discussing, thinking, arguing, listening, and evaluating one's own preconceptions after the activities, under the leadership of a thoughtful teacher, can bring this about. After all, a food fight is a hands-on activity, but about all you would learn was something about the aerodynamics of flying mashed potatoes. Our view of what students need to build their knowledge and theories about the natural world extends far beyond a hands-on activity. While it is important for students to use and interact with materials in science class, the learning comes from the sense-making of students' hands-on experiences. The colors of the trees looked like they were on fire, the reds and oranges competing with the yellows and golds. This was Nina's favorite season, but she remained silent for hours while Marie was driving. Nina had been heartbroken after losing her championship belt. Now a former champion, she was thinking of retiring from boxing. Marie, her longtime friend and trainer, shared her pain. After another silent hour, Marie and Nina saw a sign, Sable Falls. Marie thought this would be a good place for them to stop. Marie pulled over into the parking lot. Marie and Nina went down a path to watch the falls. Another sign, Watch Your Step. Rocks are slippery. They found the falls spilling out in various layers of rock. No one was there except them. Look at them. Marie pointed to movement in the water moving toward the falls. Hundreds of fish tails were flashing and catching light from the sun, moving upstream. Beneath them in the water, they saw salmon slowly moving their bodies. While Marie and Nina kept watching the salmon, a big one suddenly leapt. It threw itself up and over the rushing water above, but in vain. They were standing without a word and watching the fish struggling. Another jumped, its body spinning until it made it over the falls. Another one leapt and was washed back by the power of the water. Watching the salmon, Marie noticed Nina fixing her eyes on their continuing challenge. Nina's heart was beating fast at each leap and twist. Then, with a great push, a small one turned a complete circle and made it over the falls. He made it. Nina shouted at the success with admiration. More salmon then followed and succeeded. She felt ashamed to be looking at them. After a moment, she turned to Marie and said, Giving up is not in my vocabulary. Marie, I'll get my championship belt back. Marie nodded with a bright smile. Our training begins tomorrow. It's going to be tough. Are you ready? Walking up the path and back to the car, they could still hear the fish splashing in the water. For quite some time, science educators believed that hands-on activities were the answer to children's understanding through their participation in science-related activities. Many teachers believed that students merely engaging in activities and manipulating objects would organize the information to be gained and the knowledge to be understood into concept comprehension. Educators began to notice that the pendulum had swung too far to the hands-on component of inquiry, as they realized that the knowledge was not inherent in the materials themselves, but in the thought and metacognition about what students had done in the activity. We now know that hands-on is a dangerous phrase when speaking about learning science. The missing ingredient is the minds-on part of the instructional experience. Certainty about the knowledge intended in any activity comes from each student's recreation of concepts and discussing, thinking, arguing, listening, and evaluating one's own preconceptions after the activities, under the leadership of a thoughtful teacher, can bring this about. After all, a food fight is a hands-on activity, but about all you would learn was something about the aerodynamics of flying mashed potatoes. Our view of what students need to build their knowledge and theories about the natural world extends far beyond a hands-on activity. While it is important for students to use and interact with materials in science class, the learning comes from the sense-making of students' hands-on experiences. The colors of the trees looked like they were on fire, the reds and oranges competing with the yellows and golds. This was Nina's favorite season, but she remained silent for hours while Marie was driving. Nina had been heartbroken after losing her championship belt. Now a former champion, she was thinking of retiring from boxing. Marie, her longtime friend and trainer, shared her pain. After another silent hour, Marie and Nina saw a sign, Sable Falls. Marie thought this would be a good place for them to stop. Marie pulled over into the parking lot. Marie and Nina went down a path to watch the falls. Another sign, watch your step. Rocks are slippery. They found the falls spilling out in various layers of rock. No one was there except them. Look at them. Marie pointed to movement in the water moving toward the falls. Hundreds of fishtails were flashing and catching light from the sun, moving upstream. Beneath them in the water, they saw salmon slowly moving their bodies. While Marie and Nina kept watching the salmon, a big one suddenly leapt. It threw itself up and over the rushing water above, but in vain. They were standing without a word and watching the fish struggling. Another jumped, its body spinning until it made it over the falls. Another one leapt and was washed back by the power of the water. Watching the salmon, Marie noticed Nina fixing her eyes on their continuing challenge. Nina's heart was beating fast at each leap and twist. Then, with a great push, a small one turned a complete circle and made it over the falls. He made it. Nina shouted at the success with admiration. More salmon then followed and succeeded. She felt ashamed to be looking at them. After a moment, she turned to Marie and said, "Giving up is not in my vocabulary. Marie, I'll get my championship belt back." Marie nodded with a bright smile. "Our training begins tomorrow. It's going to be tough. Are you ready?" Walking up the path and back to the car, they could still hear the fish splashing in the water. For quite some time, science educators believed that hands-on activities were the answer to children's understanding through their participation in science-related activities. Many teachers believed that students merely engaging in activities and manipulating objects would organize the information to be gained and the knowledge to be understood into concept comprehension. Educators began to notice that the pendulum had swung too far to the hands-on component of inquiry, as they realized that the knowledge was not inherent in the materials themselves, but in the thought and metacognition about what students had done in the activity. We now know that hands-on is a dangerous phrase when speaking about learning science. The missing ingredient is the minds on part of the instructional experience. Certainty about the knowledge intended in any activity comes from each student's recreation of concepts and discussing, thinking, arguing, listening, and evaluating one's own preconceptions after the activities, under the leadership of a thoughtful teacher, can bring this about. After all, a food fight is a hands-on activity, but about all you would learn was something about the aerodynamics of flying mashed potatoes. Our view of what students need to build their knowledge and theories about the natural world extends far beyond a hands-on activity. While it is important for students to use and interact with materials in science class, the learning comes from the sense-making of students' hands-on experiences. The colors of the trees looked like they were on fire, the reds and oranges competing with the yellows and golds. This was Nina's favorite season, but she remained silent for hours while Marie was driving. Nina had been heartbroken after losing her championship belt. Now a former champion, she was thinking of retiring from boxing. Marie, her longtime friend and trainer, shared her pain. After another silent hour, Marie and Nina saw a sign, Sable Falls. Marie thought this would be a good place for them to stop. Marie pulled over into the parking lot. Marie and Nina went down a path to watch the falls. Another sign, watch your step. Rocks are slippery. They found the falls spilling out in various layers of rock. No one was there except them. Look at them. Marie pointed to movement in the water moving toward the falls. Hundreds of fishtails were flashing and catching light from the sun, moving upstream. Beneath them in the water, they saw salmon slowly moving their bodies. While Marie and Nina kept watching the salmon, a big one suddenly leapt. It threw itself up and over the rushing water above, but in vain. They were standing without a word and watching the fish struggling. Another jumped, its body spinning until it made it over the falls. Another one leapt and was washed back by the power of the water. Watching the salmon, Marie noticed Nina fixing her eyes on their continuing challenge. Nina's heart was beating fast at each leap and twist. Then, with a great push, a small one turned a complete circle and made it over the falls. He made it. Nina shouted at the success with admiration. More salmon then followed and succeeded. She felt ashamed to be looking at them. After a moment, she turned to Marie and said, "Giving up is not in my vocabulary. Marie, I'll get my championship belt back." Marie nodded with a bright smile. "Our training begins tomorrow. It's going to be tough. Are you ready?" Walking up the path and back to the car, they could still hear the fish splashing in the water. For quite some time, science educators believed that hands-on activities were the answer to children's understanding through their participation in science-related activities. Many teachers believed that students merely engaging in activities and manipulating objects would organize the information to be gained and the knowledge to be understood into concept comprehension. Educators began to notice that the pendulum had swung too far to the hands-on component of inquiry, as they realized that the knowledge was not inherent in the materials themselves, but in the thought and metacognition about what students had done in the activity. We now know that hands-on is a dangerous phrase when speaking about learning science. The missing ingredient is the minds-on part of the instructional experience. Certainty about the knowledge intended in any activity comes from each student's recreation of concepts and discussing, thinking, arguing, listening, and evaluating one's own preconceptions after the activities, under the leadership of a thoughtful teacher, can bring this about. After all, a food fight is a hands-on activity, but about all you would learn was something about the aerodynamics of flying mashed potatoes. Our view of what students need to build their knowledge and theories about the natural world extends far beyond a hands-on activity. While it is important for students to use and interact with materials in science class, the learning comes from the sense-making of students' hands-on experiences. The colors of the trees looked like they were on fire, the reds and oranges competing with the yellows and golds. This was Nina's favorite season, but she remained silent for hours while Marie was driving. Nina had been heartbroken after losing her championship belt. Now a former champion, she was thinking of retiring from boxing. Marie, her longtime friend and trainer, shared her pain. After another silent hour, Marie and Nina saw a sign, "Sable Falls." Marie thought this would be a good place for them to stop. Marie pulled over into the parking lot. Marie and Nina went down a path to watch the falls. Another sign, "Watch your step. Rocks are slippery." They found the falls spilling out in various layers of rock. No one was there except them. "Look at them." Marie pointed to movement in the water moving toward the falls. Hundreds of fish tails were flashing and catching light from the sun, moving upstream. Beneath them in the water, they saw salmon slowly moving their bodies. While Marie and Nina kept watching the salmon, a big one suddenly leapt. It threw itself up and over the rushing water above, but in vain. They were standing without a word and watching the fish struggling. Another jumped, its body spinning until it made it over the falls. Another one leapt and was washed back by the power of the water. Watching the salmon, Marie noticed Nina fixing her eyes on their continuing challenge. Nina's heart was beating fast at each leap and twist. Then, with a great push, a small one turned a complete circle and made it over the falls. He made it. Nina shouted at the success with admiration. More salmon then followed and succeeded. She felt ashamed to be looking at them. After a moment, she turned to Marie and said, "Giving up is not in my vocabulary. Marie, I'll get my championship belt back." Marie nodded with a bright smile. "Our training begins tomorrow. It's going to be tough. Are you ready?" Walking up the path and back to the car, they could still hear the fish splashing in the water. For quite some time, science educators believed that hands-on activities were the answer to children's understanding through their participation in science-related activities. Many teachers believed that students merely engaging in activities and manipulating objects would organize the information to be gained and the knowledge to be understood into concept comprehension. Educators began to notice that the pendulum had swung too far to the hands-on component of inquiry, as they realized that the knowledge was not inherent in the materials themselves, but in the thought and metacognition about what students had done in the activity. We now know that hands-on is a dangerous phrase when speaking about learning science. The missing ingredient is the minds-on part of the instructional experience. Certainty about the knowledge intended in any activity comes from each student's recreation of concepts, and discussing, thinking, arguing, listening, and evaluating one's own preconceptions after the activities, under the leadership of a thoughtful teacher, can bring this about. After all, a food fight is a hands-on activity, but about all you would learn was something about the aerodynamics of flying mashed potatoes. Our view of what students need to build their knowledge and theories about the natural world extends far beyond a hands-on activity. While it is important for students to use and interact with materials in science class, the learning comes from the sense-making of students' hands-on experiences. The colors of the trees looked like they were on fire, the reds and oranges competing with the yellows and golds. This was Nina's favorite season, but she remained silent for hours while Marie was driving. Nina had been heartbroken after losing her championship belt. Now a former champion, she was thinking of retiring from boxing. Marie, her longtime friend and trainer, shared her pain. After another silent hour, Marie and Nina saw a sign, Sable Falls. Marie thought this would be a good place for them to stop. Marie pulled over into the parking lot. Marie and Nina went down a path to watch the falls. Another sign, Watch Your Step. Rocks are slippery. They found the falls spilling out in various layers of rock. No one was there except them. Look at them. Marie pointed to movement in the water moving toward the falls. Hundreds of fishtails were flashing and catching light from the sun, moving upstream. Beneath them in the water, they saw salmon slowly moving their bodies. While Marie and Nina kept watching the salmon, a big one suddenly leapt. It threw itself up and over the rushing water above, but in vain. They were standing without a word and watching the fish struggling. Another jumped, its body spinning until it made it over the falls. Another one leapt and was washed back by the power of the water. Watching the salmon, Marie noticed Nina fixing her eyes on their continuing challenge. Nina's heart was beating fast at each leap and twist. Then, with a great push, a small one turned a complete circle and made it over the falls. He made it. Nina shouted at the success with admiration. More salmon then followed and succeeded. She felt ashamed to be looking at them. After a moment, she turned to Marie and said, "Giving up is not in my vocabulary. Marie, I'll get my championship belt back." Marie nodded with a bright smile. "Our training begins tomorrow. It's going to be tough. Are you ready?" Walking up the path and back to the car, they could still hear the fish splashing in the water. For quite some time, science educators believed that hands-on activities were the answer to children's understanding through their participation in science-related activities. Many teachers believed that students merely engaging in activities and manipulating objects would organize the information to be gained and the knowledge to be understood into concept comprehension. Educators began to notice that the pendulum had swung too far to the hands-on component of inquiry, as they realized that the knowledge was not inherent in the materials themselves, but in the thought and metacognition about what students had done in the activity. We now know that hands-on is a dangerous phrase when speaking about learning science. The missing ingredient is the minds-on part of the instructional experience. Certainty about the knowledge intended in any activity comes from each student's recreation of concepts, and discussing, thinking, arguing, listening, and evaluating one's own preconceptions after the activities, under the leadership of a thoughtful teacher, can bring this about. After all, a food fight is a hands-on activity, but about all you would learn was something about the aerodynamics of flying mashed potatoes. Our view of what students need to build their knowledge and theories about the natural world extends far beyond a hands-on activity. While it is important for students to use and interact with materials in science class, the learning comes from the sense-making of students' hands-on experiences. The colors of the trees looked like they were on fire, the reds and oranges competing with the yellows and golds. This was Nina's favorite season, but she remained silent for hours while Marie was driving. Nina had been heartbroken after losing her championship belt. Now a former champion, She was thinking of retiring from boxing. Marie, her longtime friend and trainer, shared her pain. After another silent hour, Marie and Nina saw a sign, Sable Falls. Marie thought this would be a good place for them to stop. Marie pulled over into the parking lot. Marie and Nina went down a path to watch the falls. Another sign, watch your step. Rocks are slippery. They found the falls spilling out in various layers of rock. No one was there except them. Look at them. Marie pointed to movement in the water moving toward the falls. Hundreds of fishtails were flashing and catching light from the sun, moving upstream. Beneath them in the water, they saw salmon slowly moving their bodies. While Marie and Nina kept watching the salmon, a big one suddenly leapt. It threw itself up and over the rushing water above, but in vain. They were standing without a word and watching the fish struggling. Another jumped, its body spinning until it made it over the falls. Another one leapt and was washed back by the power of the water. Watching the salmon, Marie noticed Nina fixing her eyes on their continuing challenge. Nina's heart was beating fast at each leap and twist. Then, with a great push, a small one turned a complete circle and made it over the falls. He made it. Nina shouted at the success with admiration. More salmon then followed and succeeded. She felt ashamed to be looking at them. After a moment, she turned to Marie and said, "Giving up is not in my vocabulary. Marie, I'll get my championship belt back." Marie nodded with a bright smile. "Our training begins tomorrow. It's going to be tough. Are you ready?" Walking up the path and back to the car, they could still hear the fish splashing in the water. For quite some time, science educators believed that hands-on activities were the answer to children's understanding through their participation in science-related activities. Many teachers believed that students merely engaging in activities and manipulating objects would organize the information to be gained and the knowledge to be understood into concept comprehension. Educators began to notice that the pendulum had swung too far to the hands-on component of inquiry, as they realized that the knowledge was not inherent in the materials themselves, but in the thought and metacognition about what students had done in the activity. We now know that hands-on is a dangerous phrase when speaking about learning science. The missing ingredient is the minds-on part of the instructional experience. Certainty about the knowledge intended in any activity comes from each student's recreation of concepts, and discussing, thinking, arguing, listening, and evaluating one's own preconceptions after the activities, under the leadership of a thoughtful teacher, can bring this about. After all, a food fight is a hands-on activity, but about all you would learn was something about the aerodynamics of flying mashed potatoes. Our view of what students need to build their knowledge and theories about the natural world extends far beyond a hands-on activity. While it is important for students to use and interact with materials in science class, the learning comes from the sense-making of students' hands-on experiences. The colors of the trees looked like they were on fire, the reds and oranges competing with the yellows and golds. This was Nina's favorite season, but she remained silent for hours while Marie was driving. Nina had been heartbroken after losing her championship belt. Now a former champion, she was thinking of retiring from boxing. Marie, her longtime friend and trainer, shared her pain. After another silent hour, Marie and Nina saw a sign, Sable Falls. Marie thought this would be a good place for them to stop. Marie pulled over into the parking lot. Marie and Nina went down a path to watch the falls. Another sign, watch your step. Rocks are slippery. They found the falls spilling out in various layers of rock. No one was there except them. Look at them. Marie pointed to movement in the water moving toward the falls. Hundreds of fishtails were flashing and catching light from the sun, moving upstream. Beneath them in the water, they saw salmon slowly moving their bodies. While Marie and Nina kept watching the salmon, a big one suddenly leapt. It threw itself up and over the rushing water above, but in vain. They were standing without a word and watching the fish struggling. Another jumped, its body spinning until it made it over the falls. Another one leapt and was washed back by the power of the water. Watching the salmon, Marie noticed Nina fixing her eyes on their continuing challenge. Nina's heart was beating fast at each leap and twist. Then, with a great push, a small one turned a complete circle and made it over the falls. He made it. Nina shouted at the success with admiration. More salmon then followed and succeeded. She felt ashamed to be looking at them. After a moment, she turned to Marie and said, "Giving up is not in my vocabulary. Marie, I'll get my championship belt back." Marie nodded with a bright smile. "Our training begins tomorrow. It's going to be tough. Are you ready?" Walking up the path and back to the car, they could still hear the fish splashing in the water. For quite some time, science educators believed that hands-on activities were the answer to children's understanding through their participation in science-related activities. Many teachers believed that students merely engaging in activities and manipulating objects would organize the information to be gained and the knowledge to be understood into concept comprehension. Educators began to notice that the pendulum had swung too far to the hands-on component of inquiry, as they realized that the knowledge was not inherent in the materials themselves, but in the thought and metacognition about what students had done in the activity. We now know that hands-on is a dangerous phrase when speaking about learning science. The missing ingredient is the minds-on part of the instructional experience. Certainty about the knowledge intended in any activity comes from each student's recreation of concepts, and discussing, thinking, arguing, listening, and evaluating one's own preconceptions after the activities, under the leadership of a thoughtful teacher, can bring this about. After all, a food fight is a hands-on activity, but about all you would learn was something about the aerodynamics of flying mashed potatoes. Our view of what students need to build their knowledge and theories about the natural world extends far beyond a hands-on activity. While it is important for students to use and interact with materials in science class, the learning comes from the sense-making of students' hands-on experiences. The colors of the trees looked like they were on fire, the reds and oranges competing with the yellows and golds. This was Nina's favorite season, but she remained silent for hours while Marie was driving. Nina had been heartbroken after losing her championship belt. Now a former champion, she was thinking of retiring from boxing. Marie, her longtime friend and trainer, shared her pain. After another silent hour, Marie and Nina saw a sign, "Sable Falls." Marie thought this would be a good place for them to stop. Marie pulled over into the parking lot. Marie and Nina went down a path to watch the falls. Another sign, "Watch your step. Rocks are slippery." They found the falls spilling out in various layers of rock. No one was there except them. "Look at them." Marie pointed to movement in the water moving toward the falls. Hundreds of fishtails were flashing and catching light from the sun, moving upstream. Beneath them in the water, they saw salmon slowly moving their bodies. While Marie and Nina kept watching the salmon, a big one suddenly leapt. It threw itself up and over the rushing water above, but in vain. They were standing without a word and watching the fish struggling. Another jumped, its body spinning until it made it over the falls. Another one leapt and was washed back by the power of the water. Watching the salmon, Marie noticed Nina fixing her eyes on their continuing challenge. Nina's heart was beating fast at each leap and twist. Then, with a great push, a small one turned a complete circle and made it over the falls. "He made it." Nina shouted at the success with admiration. More salmon then followed and succeeded. She felt ashamed to be looking at them. After a moment, she turned to Marie and said, "Giving up is not in my vocabulary. Marie, I'll get my championship belt back." Marie nodded with a bright smile. "Our training begins tomorrow. It's going to be tough. Are you ready?" Walking up the path and back to the car, they could still hear the fish splashing in the water. For quite some time, science educators believed that hands-on activities were the answer to children's understanding through their participation in science-related activities. Many teachers believed that students merely engaging in activities and manipulating objects would organize the information to be gained and the knowledge to be understood into concept comprehension. Educators began to notice that the pendulum had swung too far to the hands-on component of inquiry, as they realized that the knowledge was not inherent in the materials themselves, but in the thought and metacognition about what students had done in the activity. We now know that hands-on is a dangerous phrase when speaking about learning science. The missing ingredient is the minds-on part of the instructional experience. Certainty about the knowledge intended in any activity comes from each student's recreation of concepts and discussing, thinking, arguing, listening, and evaluating one's own preconceptions after the activities, under the leadership of a thoughtful teacher, can bring this about. After all, a food fight is a hands-on activity, but about all you would learn was something about the aerodynamics of flying mashed potatoes. Our view of what students need to build their knowledge and theories about the natural world extends far beyond a hands-on activity. While it is important for students to use and interact with materials in science class, the learning comes from the sense-making of students' hands-on experiences. The colors of the trees looked like they were on fire, the reds and oranges competing with the yellows and golds. This was Nina's favorite season, but she remained silent for hours while Marie was driving. Nina had been heartbroken after losing her championship belt. Now a former champion, she was thinking of retiring from boxing. Marie, her longtime friend and trainer, shared her pain. After another silent hour, Marie and Nina saw a sign, Sable Falls. Marie thought this would be a good place for them to stop. Marie pulled over into the parking lot. Marie and Nina went down a path to watch the falls. Another sign, Watch Your Step. Rocks are slippery. They found the falls spilling out in various layers of rock. No one was there except them. Look at them. Marie pointed to movement in the water moving toward the falls. Hundreds of fishtails were flashing and catching light from the sun, moving upstream. Beneath them in the water, they saw salmon slowly moving their bodies. While Marie and Nina kept watching the salmon, a big one suddenly leapt. It threw itself up and over the rushing water above, but in vain. They were standing without a word and watching the fish struggling. Another jumped, its body spinning until it made it over the falls. Another one leapt and was washed back by the power of the water. Watching the salmon, Marie noticed Nina fixing her eyes on their continuing challenge. Nina's heart was beating fast at each leap and twist. Then, with a great push, a small one turned a complete circle and made it over the falls. He made it. Nina shouted at the success with admiration. More salmon then followed and succeeded. She felt ashamed to be looking at them. After a moment, she turned to Marie and said, "Giving up is not in my vocabulary. Marie, I'll get my championship belt back." Marie nodded with a bright smile. "Our training begins tomorrow. It's going to be tough. Are you ready?" Walking up the path and back to the car, they could still hear the fish splashing in the water. For quite some time, science educators believed that hands-on activities were the answer to children's understanding through their participation in science-related activities. Many teachers believed that students merely engaging in activities and manipulating objects would organize the information to be gained and the knowledge to be understood into concept comprehension. Educators began to notice that the pendulum had swung too far to the hands-on component of inquiry, as they realized that the knowledge was not inherent in the materials themselves, but in the thought and metacognition about what students had done in the activity. We now know that hands-on is a dangerous phrase when speaking about learning science. The missing ingredient is the minds-on part of the instructional experience. Certainty about the knowledge intended in any activity comes from each student's recreation of concepts and discussing, thinking, arguing, listening, and evaluating one's own preconceptions after the activities, under the leadership of a thoughtful teacher, can bring this about. After all, a food fight is a hands-on activity, but about all you would learn was something about the aerodynamics of flying mashed potatoes. Our view of what students need to build their knowledge and theories about the natural world extends far beyond a hands-on activity. While it is important for students to use and interact with materials in science class, the learning comes from the sense-making of students' hands-on experiences. The colors of the trees looked like they were on fire, the reds and oranges competing with the yellows and golds. This was Nina's favorite season, but she remained silent for hours while Marie was driving. Nina had been heartbroken after losing her championship belt. Now a former champion, she was thinking of retiring from boxing. Marie, her longtime friend and trainer, shared her pain. After another silent hour, Marie and Nina saw a sign, Sable Falls. Marie thought this would be a good place for them to stop. Marie pulled over into the parking lot. Marie and Nina went down a path to watch the falls. Another sign, Watch Your Step. Rocks are slippery. They found the falls spilling out in various layers of rock. No one was there except them. Look at them. Marie pointed to movement in the water moving toward the falls. Hundreds of fishtails were flashing and catching light from the sun, moving upstream. Beneath them in the water, they saw salmon slowly moving their bodies. While Marie and Nina kept watching the salmon, a big one suddenly leapt. It threw itself up and over the rushing water above, but in vain. They were standing without a word and watching the fish struggling. Another jumped, its body spinning until it made it over the falls. Another one leapt and was washed back by the power of the water. Watching the salmon, Marie noticed Nina fixing her eyes on their continuing challenge. Nina's heart was beating fast at each leap and twist. Then, with a great push, a small one turned a complete circle and made it over the falls. He made it. Nina shouted at the success with admiration. More salmon then followed and succeeded. She felt ashamed to be looking at them. After a moment, she turned to Marie and said, "Giving up is not in my vocabulary. Marie, I'll get my championship belt back." Marie nodded with a bright smile. "Our training begins tomorrow. It's going to be tough. Are you ready?" Walking up the path and back to the car, they could still hear the fish splashing in the water.